Today we have a, I have the honor of presenting the Distinguished Service Award to a personal friend. That doesn't always happen. Chuck Wooten. Chuck, this is really a bittersweet day, I will tell you. This university has come a long way over the last 15 years. If you walk around the campus, it's really easy to get lost. My wife rags me because we went away for the 1 2-week vacation we have ever had since I came here. And when I got back, Chuck had moved a road. And I got lost in the middle of campus. I actually had to call my office and say, how the heck do I get? And they never will let me forget that, because that's really true. A great university doesn't become great because a person decides that something's going to happen. It becomes great because people buy in and they push the institution up the hill. And they keep moving it forward with greater and greater momentum. And Chuck Wooten is one of those people. He's a graduate of the university. He got his degree here, the only place to which he applied. A friend told him, next door neighbor said, you ought to look at Western. He came out, looked at Western, and applied and came to the campus. And it's something that we heard today a couple of times. When they got here, this was the right place. And you can all boo after this one, but he went on and got his master's degree at Appalachian. but had the great good sense to come home. And I was 99% sure we would never hire anyone from inside Western to be the next finance officer, because we needed to really think differently about how we did finance. And so Chuck applied for the job, and he blew everybody else in the pool away. It wasn't even a question as to who you hire. And so for the last decade, Chuck has been a true friend and partner in developing this university. Now, the blessing that we have is he and his wife are not leaving this community. They're going to stay here. He's going to continue working with athletics. I also know his phone number, and I know where he lives. So he isn't going to really get to escape. But truly, I mean, we can go through, you can read the formal document, but I think that really what you're seeing here today, we are honoring a man for his service, but truly we are honoring the spirit of Western Carolina University. Chuck.
Thank you for those very kind comments, Chancellor Bardo. I'm truly honored to receive this award. I would also like to express my appreciation to Betty Allen and to the Alumni Board for selecting me to receive this honor. It was a real surprise to get Marty Ramsey's letter, and I am very, very honored. First, I want to say it's been a real privilege to work side by side with Chancellor Bardo over the past 10 years. He truly has a vision for Western Carolina University, and the campus has benefited greatly from his leadership. Just take a look around the campus, see the changes not only in the physical plan, but also in the quantity and the quality of our students who are currently enrolled. Thank you, Chancellor Bardo, for giving me the opportunity to serve in my current role as Vice Chancellor. When I reflect on my career, I'm reminded of the foundation and the mentors that supported me each step along the way. First, my parents were always supportive of my interests and gave me every opportunity to succeed. While a student at Western, I always found the faculty to be interested in the well-being of their students. Western is very fortunate to have men and women who are outstanding at what they do, and these people have a work ethic that cannot be duplicated. My years at Western have truly been a labor of love. I feel very fortunate to have spent the majority of my professional career in a position that never got old, and always offered another opportunity. Thank you.